Welcome to Potsdam Butterflies number 3. It's our third and final show of the 2015 butterfly season. I'm Ron Ryle, your host. Our sponsor for today's show is Citadel Federal Credit Union. They're located at 401 Upland Square Road. It's a great place to bank. I hope you'll consider them when you're thinking about your banking needs. This show is about the monarch migration. The monarch migration is an interesting topic. The migration, the last 2 years, 2012 and would be 2013 and 2014, was very poor. The monarch numbers were way down. This year, though, in 2015, the monarchs are doing much better. We are seeing as many as 100 monarchs per day coming through the backyard in Pottstown. Pottstown Butterflies number 3, the monarch migration, as the traffic goes by here on Route 100 and Upland Square. The monarchs would be migrating to Mexico all through September. At our house, the migration started on September 6th. We've had a wonderful migration. Today, it's September 22nd. The monarchs are still migrating in nice numbers. The background of the migration starts with the discovery of the site in Mexico. It was discovered by Dr. Fred Urquhart. He kind of kept it a secret, and he did tell National Geographic, and in August of 1976, National Geographic ran a story on the overwintering site in Mexico, and that would be El Rosario. It's located 10,000 feet up. Nobody thought the monarchs would be there because it's too cold. It has to be 65 to 70 degrees for a monarch to even fly. But that's where they were. They roost on trees, one on top of another, as far as maybe 36 inches out on the trees to keep warm. So no one really looked there. And Dr. Fred Urquhart kept this kind of a secret to the different scientists in the United States. And then Dr. Lincoln Brower and his associate, Dr. Bill Calvert, figured out where the site, overwintering site was in Mexico, since it was being kept a secret. And they went down there and discovered the monarchs in El Rosario, 10,000 feet up. The site is west of Mexico City. Angangueo is the town at the bottom of the mountain. They do have a butterfly festival there every year in Angangueo. The migration has been studied by the University of Kansas since 1992. They've had a monarch tagging program since then. I started to participate 14 years ago in the year 2002. So the monarch research has really just begun in 1992. It's relatively new, makes it kind of exciting. We don't know why the monarchs go to Mexico. All the other butterflies overwinter as a chrysalis, and the monarch butterfly in the summertime only lives 4 weeks, and in the wintertime, the batch of monarchs that leaves in September for Mexico overwinters as a butterfly. These butterflies live for 7 months. They go back to Texas in the spring, in March, and they lay eggs on the milkweed, and the next generation of monarchs born there in Texas comes up north, and we hope they reach Pennsylvania. They do go as far as Canada. Most of the monarchs fly straight up the Mississippi, Mississippi River, that is. And that's why the monarch numbers are down. The big farms along the Mississippi, the farmers use Roundup to kill all the milkweed on those big 1,000 acre farms. So milkweed is disappearing. Please plant milkweed to help get the monarch numbers up. Save the monarchs, plant milkweed. Potsdam Butterflies, Potsdam Butterflies number 3 is about to begin. A couple of things before we get started, before I introduce our tagging team for today's show. There's one thing you're going to need to see the migration come through your backyard. The migration is invisible. It's going on all around us unless you have this one particular flower, and that is a Mexican sunflower. Mexican sunflower brings the migration right through your backyard. It grows 6 to 8 feet tall, and it's terrific when it blooms in September for the migration. Before we go too much further, I want to show you how to find the sex of each monarch. We're going to need that to record our data on our monarch tagging sheet, so I'll do that next. I wanted to show you a close-up of a female monarch. On the bottom two wings, there are no black dots on those bottom two wings. That'd be just right below my thumb is where the bottom two wings are wings are located. I will try to show you a close-up of the male monarch next. And here's the male monarch. You can see the black dots on the bottom two wings. That's where the pheromones are, and they actually attract the female monarch. So you can definitely see those two black dots just to the right and left of the abdomen there. So that's the male monarch. I'd like to introduce our crew for Pottstown Butterflies number 3, the Monarch Migration. I mentioned earlier it's sponsored by Citadel Federal Credit Union. They're located at Upland Square in Pottstown. We have the branch manager Ryan with us with his wife Angie. They're our tagging netting crew. They're going to catch the monarchs and apply the tags as we go. So here we go. We're going to start trying to catch the monarchs. It's September 19th in the backyard. Temperature is about 84 degrees. So it's a great day for flying, and hopefully we'll be able to get lots of monarchs. Okay, Ryan, good catch. Awesome. Got him in the net. All right, we're off to the races here in the backyard in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. The monarch migration. Okay, we have Angie making her attempt here to catch this monarch. Butterfly Angie here with the net. Oh, didn't get him on that one, but the monarch is still here flying around. Here it comes over here. And, almost. Good try. That was awesome. Butterfly Angie, that was her. We have another monarch that just came in, and Angie's taking a... She's got it! A good catch, all right. Wow. Okay, very good. We've just applied a tag to the first monarch that we captured, and Angie is holding it here, and I'm trying to zoom in to get the tag number for you. It's UGY... What is it? UGY 455. I actually see it in the lens. So we're getting ready to release it. And let's just walk out here past the table here, Angie. And we'll let it go and see if it goes southwest. Go ahead and
let it go.
Put it out in your hand like this and then let it go. And there it goes off in the southwest direction. I don't think I was able to get it. Next, Ryan is going to apply a tag to the monarch. The tag is applied to the discal cell. It's the largest cell on the monarch butterfly. And go ahead and see if you can put that on, Ryan. And 3M is the manufacturer of the tags. They're very sticky. Keep in mind these butterflies are going to fly over 2,000 miles to Mexico. And that's a long ways. And Ryan's got it on there. He's using a toothpick to apply the tag. And now we're ready for the release. And let's see if we can see this one. The last one flew so fast southwest we didn't have a chance. And there he goes, and it's going mostly south, starting to look a little west, and anyway, it's going south. Angie's going to find out what sex the butterfly is next, and as we tag our third monarch of the day here on September 19th in the backyard in Pottstown.
How did you do it? I'm sorry, I don't want to... Heard it.
They're hard to separate. These butterflies are very feisty. They know they have to go to Mexico. They don't mate. Yep. They fly straight there.
There we go.
As Ryan chips in, and so far I'm seeing female. I don't see the dots. And we have our first female. There's no dots as the butterfly almost escapes. These butterflies are very feisty. And now Angie's going to apply the tag with the toothpick. And I got to find the butterfly again in the lens. Okay, we're getting there. Thanks, Angie. And she's putting the tag on the big cell there. And those black lines on the monarch are like a skeleton. This is the strongest butterfly that I know of, the monarch butterfly. Angie, if you'll just hold that still, I want to move in and see if we can pick up that tag number again. And could you read it off to us?
UGY457.
Yes, I think I do see it. And now we're ready for the release.
Okay. Let's get out
here. Here we go. And they're so hard to see when they take off here. And southwest right away, the butterfly went. I'm sorry I wasn't able to pick it up. Angie's going to record the data on the sheet. And could you tell us what you're putting on there?
I am putting the tag number.
Okay.
The date. Then, that was our first female of the day. So.
Okay, the sex.
Female.
And
wild.
It was wild, in the wild.
And in Pottstown.
Pottstown. And this is September 19th. This is normally the peak migration. This year, migration is going to run a little later than normal from the reports we're getting from different people. So we're going to have an extensive butterfly season. Monarch Watch runs the program, and that's these folks here on the orange envelope. They're University of Kansas. That's where you buy your tags. If you want to tag monarchs, you order your tags in July, and it usually costs like $25. And they send you the tags right to your home. If you need a butterfly net, try monarchwatch.org or BioQuip in California. Two great sources to buy a butterfly net. That's something you'll need if you decide you want to tag the monarch butterfly. Unless you raise them, of course, you wouldn't need the net. So a lot of people do raise the monarch butterflies in our area. And Ryan's going to try to capture another one on the Mexican sunflower.
Should get out?
He got it, he got it. He thought he missed it. He got it. Good catch, Ryan. All right.
Good eye.
Way to go. Here he comes with the monarch in the net. All right, beautiful. Dynamite. There it is. Are you having fun?
Yeah.
Good, good, good.
Are you sure you guys want to keep it? It's in there.
Ryan's taking his butterfly out of the net now, and he's going to check the sex of the monarch butterfly. We'll record it on the data sheet. We'll be sending the data sheets down to the University of Kansas in November once we're all done with our migration. He got the butterfly out just fine. Now he's trying to open the wings up. It's tricky because they're so feisty. This last batch of monarchs is a brighter orange. And they're just a beautiful version of the monarch. The last batch, they don't mate. They fly straight to Mexico. And so what do we have here? Do we have any dots? Right there it is. Yeah, it's a male.
Okay,
Ryan's going to put on a tag here on the discal cell, on that big cell in the back of the butterfly, on the UGY-458, preparing for takeoff for Mexico. And the butterflies overwinter as a butterfly for 7 months, and then they fly back in March to Texas, where they lay eggs on the milkweed. And okay, I think we're ready to release. And there goes the butterfly, another one going southwest. So we had, they all went southwest except for the one that went south. Ryan's recording the data on the data sheet of the male monarch that he just released. The butterfly just left for Mexico. The monarch migration, prime time is late September. Usually at our house, the busiest time is usually this week coming up, right around the 19th, that's today's date. I did have a monarch recovered in Mexico. It left here on September 21st, 2003, was recovered March 1st in 2004 in Rosario, Mexico. Rosario is located 10,000 feet up. The monarchs roost on the fir trees and they spend the winter there. At the bottom of the mountain is a town called Angangueo. You may remember they had a mudslide there about 3 years ago. I'm sorry to say, I believe about 50 people were killed in that mudslide. So they do have a monarch celebration in Anguayo. They have a monarch festival at the bottom of the mountain as the monarchs make their return for the winter to Mexico. Angie's going out for another monarch. She just spotted one over on the Bud Leon butterfly bush, that is. And did she get it? I don't know. She got it! All right, another nice catch. All right, Angie.
All right.
Okay.
nice.
Good catch. Good catch.
That's a big one.
Yes.
Big guy must have ate a lot of milkweed.
Yeah.
Plant milkweed, folks. Save the monarchs. The farmers, when they use their Roundup, they're killing all the milkweed. The monarch population is hurting, so plant your milkweed. That's the plant that the monarch depends on. It lays eggs on milkweed. That's the host plant, in other words. So, Angie's pulling it out already out of the net. She is going strong here. She's getting the sex of the butterfly as Ryan goes over to get a tag ready. And we're rolling here in the backyard in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. It's the monarch migration. Pottstown butterflies number 3. It's our final video of the season. And what do we have? You almost got it split open there. Okay, good, behind the head. Try to open it from the top.
Top, okay.
Yeah, use your finger. Very nice, very good. It's a male, there's the dots, and
okay.
A good shot of the dots. Very, okay. Very nice, that's the male.
Oh, you got it?
Ryan's got the tag out already.
I know. We're ready to go.
We're going strong on this one. And there's that disco cell I was telling you about. We're getting a good shot. As Angie applies the tag, not too tight, not too loose. And it's UGY something.
459.
UGY459 as I try to get that here. We're a little bit in the shade. And we're ready for the release.
All right.
Wow, we're just cruising along here on this one. In the backyard. Okay, it's staying in her hand here. Off it goes. Oh my goodness, it's going east.
Uh-oh.
It's going east. It's going to Philadelphia.
No.
Oh my goodness. That's not Mexico. Get back here. Get back here. Oh well, that's the way it goes.
Oh, he's coming back around.
Is he coming back?
Yeah, he looks like he was going around.
Oh yeah, making it. Ryan's going out for another attempt here. As the monarch flies around. Wait, he'll probably land. The butterfly's still flying around here in the backyard. I'm trying to follow it and not able to. There he is, way over there.
Did he stop?
And he's on the Mexican sunflower. Tithonia, that's their favorite, folks. If you'd like to see the migration at your house, plant Mexican sunflower as Ryan moves in for the catch. And he's there. And did he get him?
No.
Says he got away. Well, it was a good attempt, good attempt. These butterflies are very feisty when they're on their way to Mexico. They're not easy to catch. So far, all the butterflies except for one have been on Mexican sunflower. One was on butterfly bush. So Mexican sunflower is native to Mexico. The monarchs recognize it. That's where they're headed, folks. They're going to Mexico. Another monarch has just come into the backyard. Angie's gonna make an attempt. It's on Mexican sunflower. And did she get it?
No.
Got away?
No, he's still here.
Still here, huh?
Still here.
Second chance. You don't get that often during migration. Wow, you got a touch with these monarchs. Man, you must be, they must, there he goes by. He's going over there.
Don't go.
Coming in now.
Another monarch has just flown in as we're really getting busy here. We had 11 in the first hour. Not too bad. Not a real busy migration as Angie's over at the Mexican sunflower trying to reel another one in. Let's see if she can do it.
No.
Got away. It's still flying around though over there. And she's gonna try to make another attempt. And she tried it in midair.
I know, I tried to get him.
That would have been a neat catch, folks. Couldn't pull it off as we have a hummingbird over in the Mexican sunflower. Ryan's gonna give it a shot now. Okay, we got another monarch.
There's another one.
Another one. Wow. They're really coming in all of a sudden. They must have come in together. They do that sometimes.
There you go.
And
you had him, but he got away.
He got away. She had him, but the monarch got away.
Yeah. Come back there, though.
Yeah, there's I can't tell one from the other now. There's monarchs galore here.
Can you see him?
Ryan's going over to make an attempt here on the... I don't know.
There he is.
All right.
You got him.
I think he got him.
along with that whole tree.
That's okay. That's all right. Good catch. Great, great catch. It was a straight down move there. You folks, you might have seen that one. A little different way than the loop method. And that's Ryan, the manager up at Citadel. He did it, man. He catches those butterflies with ease. Ryan says this butterfly is very feisty. He's trying to get it out of the net, but it's just fluttering away. The last batch of monarchs is very, very feisty. They're tough, but they're difficult to catch, folks. It's not as easy as it would seem. The monarchs in the summertime are a little more tame, because they're not. Their destiny is not Mexico, but these guys, all right, he's trying to get the sex of the monarch. And then, yep, he's got it down. He's got the method down. He split it up at the top by the head.
It's female?
And,
or no, that's male.
There's that black dot again, another male. All right, another male. He's got another male. As we come over to get a tag here, I've got one on the toothpick right here for you. And he's going to put the tag on that disco cell. We're getting a nice shot here. Finally learning how to do this. There we are. UGY. Yeah?
Yep. 460.
460 on the way to Mexico. And good luck. Hope to see you back. The next generation, that is. He's just hanging out. Okay. Off he goes. Oh, he's going to Philly again. Another one going to Philadelphia. Why is he going east? I got that one. Okay, Sneaky's the cat, you're on. And Sneaky's, thanks for letting me know that one monarch was born. It was laying flat in the cage. And they have to hang up to dry out. Otherwise, they end up with curled wings and they can't fly anywhere. So thanks to our cat, Sneaky. She's a great butterfly watcher as the monarchs are up high on the furniture, so she can't bat him around, but she's a great butterfly watcher, and she just saved this monarch's life. Thanks again, girl, for all the great work you do with the butterflies. We have three butterflies born here this morning on September 20th. I raised these butterflies from caterpillars. I was able to find them on Jackson Road. Thanks, Mr. Frame, for letting me in your field to get these caterpillars, and now they've hatched into monarchs. The one on the far left is the one the cat just saved. The chrysalis was flat on the in the cage, and the butterflies have to hang when they're drying out. It takes about 2 hours for them to dry out. They're usually born around 8 o'clock in the morning. It's 9 o'clock right now. Another one just popped out in the back. So this is when it's all happening, early in the morning, and then it takes about 2 hours for them to dry, then they can fly. So they're drying out. The one on the far left is still curled up and would not have made it if it wasn't for our cat Sneakies. She alerted me to one of them being born. She was watching him from the table, and then I went over and saw the one laying flat in the cage and hung it up on an old chrysalis that a monarch had already emerged from. So it's hanging now, and I think it's going to make it. And here we are with three butterflies born. This morning we're having a great monarch season, and you can see there's some more chrysalises hanging, and you can see the one that's turning dark in the back. That means another monarch is getting ready to come out of that one. It turns black. It's a jade green to begin with a gold trim, and then it turns black and then clear, and the butterfly pops out. Out of that little chrysalis, a monarch butterfly comes out with a wingspan of approximately 4 inches, 3.5 to 4 inches. So they're all scrunched up, as you see the one here that the cat helped me out with. It's trying to expand, and hopefully it's going to make it, thanks to Sneaky's the cat. Unfortunately, I don't have a good report on the butterfly that our cat alerted me on. This butterfly is not going to be able to expand its wings, and it's not going to be able to make it to Mexico. It's going to spend the rest of its life out here in the backyard in Pottstown. This happens sometimes. Those of you who raise monarchs, I know you have the same problems. And we had one butterfly monarch born in the wild in the backyard the other day that had the same exact problem. So nature is not a perfect world, and Anyway, this is what happened to the butterfly that I thought was going to be okay that our cat alerted us to. So this is the outcome. It's unfortunate, but it does happen in nature. And luckily, most of the other butterflies are going to make it. Sorry, girl. Poor Sneakies. Your butterfly, well, it's going to spend the rest of its life in Pennsylvania. But you can see we have five more in the cage there for you, cat. And anyway, looks like the rest of them are going to be just fine. Nice try, girl. We're getting ready to close our show here, Pottstown Butterflies in 2015. Our last video, the season was kind of an up and down season. In fact, today is September 23rd, and this is usually prime time for monarch migration. And I was saying I thought the migration was going to be late, but actually it may have already occurred as far as the peak time, and that would be September 6th through September 19th. And the 20th and 21st we had pretty good numbers, but not as strong as the ones previously. We had about 100 monarchs a day, so things are looking up. In the old days we used to get, during peak migration, 200 monarchs per day. So it was definitely a much better year. As we get ready to close, the numbers of butterflies, the other species besides the monarchs were up. The other species, there were a lot of species, but the quantity of butterflies was down for the third year in a row. So the quantities are really hurting. We try to get 50 butterflies a day in the backyard. In the last 3 years, we've been lucky to get 25 butterflies a day. So this year we did tie our record, though, 39 species here in, at 344 West Beach Street in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. And I'll show you a list of those that I typed up here. We did have one new species, that would be the little yellow. It's a sulfur butterfly. So we had the little yellow. Hopefully you saw Pottstown Butterflies number 2. The little yellow was on that film. So it was kind of an up and down year. I would say we had a good year, though. A lot of excitement, especially with the migration. Seeing those monarch numbers back up again, it was something really nice to see. We're harvesting our milkweed. We have a lot of pods on the table here. And we have, this is common milkweed. And we have a dish of seeds here. Probably have almost a couple thousand seeds in there. So we have 200 milkweeds on the property. And that helps us get caterpillars. This year we had 15 caterpillars, although I did raise 53 total, but only 15 from our property here, which was way up from the 3 caterpillars I had last year. I found them on swamp milkweed. One caterpillar was found on butterfly weed, Asclepias tuberosa, and everything else was common milkweed. Common milkweed is the more popular one of the three, but they will use all three of those. They're all native to Pennsylvania. And we do have a cage of monarchs we're going to let loose here at the end. They all have their tags on. We have a sponge with sugar water in the bottom. Okay, we're getting ready to tell our monarchs goodbye, and off to Mexico they're going. And we wish them the best of luck here as I open up the top of the cage to let them go. And here they go. Hopefully they'll find some of our tags. And all right, guys, you can go. Come on. Coming out of the cage, slowly but sure. Landing on my hand there. Get the rest of them going. Come on, take off. There they go. Another one. We still have 4 monarchs in the cage here as they go off to Mexico. And thanks again to Citadel Federal Credit Union for sponsoring our show. We'll see you in 2016 as we release the last butterflies here in the cage. As I reach in to get them, they don't want to come out. So we'll give them a hand. There goes one off to Mexico. Another one going, and we have 2 to go. 2 more to go. There's one at the top. Come on, head out. Come on, go to Mexico. Off to Mexico, and then the last one. There they go. See you next year. This is Ron Ryle signing off.